Aachen is now a border city. That means three countries meet. It's the most western area of Germany. And one main street leads to Holland, another main street leads to Belgium. And we are constantly hopping borders. Just because the yogurt is better in Holland, you go there, but the petrol is cheaper in Belgium, so you go there. Mm. And it's a peculiarity, and that was what intrigued me to become part and to become a partner. So I want to talk about a landscape more than people, although maybe one is linked with the other. So my talk is about a landscape and its residents. Understanding the place where one lives helps one to become comfortable, to relax, to feel good. Being an insider means to be at home. Walking through a park and knowing its history or the reason why it is a definite decision to drink this tap water gives a person a sense of orientation, of connection, of security. These applies to all people from any given area, local ones as well as newcomers. Through the project Seeing Stories, we were given the opportunity to do a lot of research, thinking, and experimenting. We could compare local narratives with oral tradition in different countries by meeting local experts here or there, by traveling there and experiencing the tales at each site. We were looking for answers by asking for stories. For instance, Aachen's earliest mentioned name is Aquegrani, referring to a Greek and a Celtic god. But there are no Celtic tales left with us. So are there any Celtic tales about that specific god? Or is it just a coincidence? We got old tales which were brought back to Aachen, completing a picture of a Celtic time which still is found in parts in the ground, but and in a few names of places. So we recovered, in a way, lost memories and could complete something for us nowadays. We decided to address all what we found through story walks, walking around an area and telling stories, but so that the landscape is allowed to be heard and we can experience local memories, old wife tales, names of places, and connect one with the other. Each of the story walks we designed have a central idea. So, and five of the walks are directly linked to Charlemagne, because he is the founder of Aachen, about whom we know a lot. He was a real person, and he is a myth. Was he real, the first European, or is it just something that people decided he could be? So here, two things come together, and we can explore them. And we chose as our historical partner Abul Abbas. Abul Abbas is an elephant which really lived in Aachen. He was given by Harun al-Rashid to Charlemagne. It took this elephant 2 years to make the journey from Baghdad through the Alps to Aachen. And he lived there for a while, but you can't find any memory of him in the city. Neither where he lived, where was his stable, nor in the tales, Just once in a while this name pops up, that's all. But who was he? Can we reintroduce him, make him there, so that you walk the streets of Aachen and all of a sudden you say, oh yeah, that was the Roman place where Abul Abbas actually lived. And a little bit down the street, there we have the statue of a very strange creature. We call him Barkauf. But Barkauf is an abbreviation of Bachkalb, which means the calf of the creek, which again refers to a Celtic god. So, did Abul Abbas actually meet this Celtic god, which was killed by the father of Charlemagne because he wanted to get rid of the old faith and started Christianity? Can we come up with new ideas and invention, and at the same time by introducing Harun al-Rashid and the Arab world to the most western part of Germany, a link between cultures? So all of these ideas are in our minds, and all of these ideas are being now trying to be brought in into story walks. So that is our approach. We are not there yet to start tell resistance stories. It's too close to the war for us Germans yet, but maybe an idea to be done now because all of them are dead. Yeah, that's the way. But we go at the moment into the very past. One walk came up, and that differs from the others. This one starts long before Charlemagne settles here, builds the cathedral, and creates, with the help of the best scholar of the then known world and empire. It is a story of what might happen when intangible cultural heritage awakens from its Dornröschenschlaf, starts to speak, and is heard. This talk and walk is called Willkommen zu Hause, Welcome Home. Aquis Grani, Aix la Chapelle, Bath Aachen, sprudelnde Vielfalt, bubbling variety, Aachen. Those are just the names through the century of that city. A landscape that acquired its present state 10,000 years ago. An area filled with hot springs, clear creeks, flint and coal. A territory populated by the abundance of special plants and animals. A land that drew new Stone Age people to it as well as Celts, Germanic tribes, Romans, Franks, and today a multicultural crowd is living in Aachen. A land of trade and worship, of healing and science. A land with a geological anomaly in its earth layers. Nobody knows why it's different from others. They are still doing research on this and they can't find it. It's not because of the volcanic area, which is very close. It's not because of the earthquakes that happen regularly in Aachen. It's not because of the hot springs. They do not know why there is a certain warmth in this land. They are still doing research. But that this is, was in the minds of the people, but I come to it later. A land where goddesses walked the land and guarded it. You will find stone goddesses everywhere around, some of them thousands of years old. An area where the Mother Earth is present, giving beauty, abundance, and knowledge to those who are living in harmony with her. Some of the just mentioned things are facts, proven by archaeological findings and historical documents. The rest, the Mother Earth, the goddesses, are myths. Hidden in urban legends, old wives' tales, chance encounters with local people who mentioned these things, names as of places as well, and as in the history of European mythology and keepers of the stories. I, myself, grew up in Aachen. I heard its local narratives of places, people, the devil and Charlemagne in elementary school. And it is still taught today. All those local legends everybody knows. I told the stories to visitors and friends from outside when walking through the city. All the locals are still doing it, as well as the many tour guides who are telling about the building of the cathedral and the role of the devil in it, how he, the devil, was tricked by the people of Aachen, how he, the devil, is responsible for the two sand hills, and that you can feel a part of his thumb in the bronze doors of the cathedral. Everybody goes and touches. And the one my grandmother told me about Charlemagne, which was hardly known until recently. And this was the tale why he settled here. And this tale is called The Ring of Frastrada. I give you an abbreviation of it. Karl, Charlemagne, I call him Karl now, yes, helped a snake who in return gave him a magical ring that had the power to bind him to whoever was wearing it. First, giving it to his third wife, Frastrada, it ended up with Turpin, his chaplain, who threw it into one of the creeks around Aachen, and Karl decided to settle down in that place. What do we get? A snake, a ring, magical power, and water. Is it a fairy tale for children, or does it contain more? I remembered my grandmother telling us that she can't leave Aachen as she gets immediately homesick. When I once asked her why, she mentioned the water of Aachen and drinking too much of it. You can't leave. Water? Looking at the landscape at the time of Karl, one pictures dozens of hot springs, the clearest creeks, with the softest waters, surrounded by woods, filled with game, wild, undisturbed, uninhabited. So it was thought of until 10 years ago. Carefully examined historical documents and archaeological findings show now a different picture. This place has been settled since the hot spring surfaced 10,000 years ago, and that the people living here always honored and worshipped a mother goddess. Her existence was evident through the water, the cold one, and the hot springs, because the old tales, the Celtic old tales, say hot springs are her eyes, creeks are her veins, and so both so abundantly found within a few miles. Traces of names of stone reliefs and documents show that her name changed through the years, turning from Kybele to Isis or Aini, to Mater Deum, to Matrona, to Mary, depending on the people who lived here. There were always trade in Aachen, stones, an abundance, a treasure of fur. And the trade changed from flintstones to knowledge, to garment industry, to science. Her place of worship and honor through 10,000 years never changed. The settlements around changed, but her place never ever changed. It was first so thought of a tree circle. It changed to a stone circle. It changed to a temple. It changed to a chapel. It changed to a cathedral, which is now a world cultural heritage. And the stories? There is a whispering of a certain strange creature living in the waters, Barkauf. There is the oldest documented name, Aquigrani, who is Granus. And who is a Celtic water god, who actually is Grandwish, a goddess, the goddess of water and light. And there are the farmers' wives selling their wares at the market, wearing wooden clogs during the harshest winters. And when you ask them, why do you wear this? Because normally you need fur, really big fur boots, they say, no. Because you wear wooden shoes, because the wood leads her warmth into our feet. I remember my grandmother getting buckets of hot water from the fountain to clean the house or do the cooking. And she said, we belong to the place, and this place belongs to us. Water round, water abundance. But if you visit my city nowadays, you won't see the waters. The people, the officials decided water. Water coming out here, water coming out there. Water smelling like rotten eggs, sulfur stench. Therefore, the devil's stories. It stinks. Who wants to go to a place that stinks? We have to get rid of this. So they suppressed the waters. They closed down one hot spa after another in the middle, in the center of the town. You don't see the water, you don't smell the water. And what is happening? The city is dying. People are not coming. In one of the main streets, you will see empty places because there is no difference from this place to another where there is nothing. But maybe it has a chance to change if the city people will understand. Because she, if she exists, is still around. Because if you go to a certain place, it thrives. It's a bit to the left side. If you're standing with your back to the bronze doors of the cathedral and you're walking towards Holland, there, seven springs are bubbling peacefully, undisturbed. Next to them, around them, the university is constructing a new campus. Building up after building, science department after science department is shooting up, bringing beauty, abundance, and knowledge to faculty, staff, and students. Maybe she is honored there. Maybe the next name after Mary nowadays is science, a female in German language. Thank you.